this afternoon from Schneider Electric is Jess Maddren. Jess, good to meet you. Good afternoon.
Thanks, Andrew. Nice to meet you too.
Jess, you'll be giving a speech at the upcoming IMARC conference discussing real-time optimised processing plants. What are some of the key messages you're hoping to impart on the audience?
It's a great topic. It's moving faster than any of us can actually keep up with, whether it be in the end user or in the suppliers or the OEMs. What an exciting place to be. And as you can see on my screen there, sustainability is the real driver behind it, because mining and the metals and the minerals that we take out is driving our change in sustainability into the new energy landscape in copper, aluminium, nickel, lithium, etc. But we can do it in a sustainable manner. So having all the technology available to be connected and drive that efficiency and sustainability is really important. So we'll talk a bit about that at the conference and in my presentation.
I suppose just interestingly, when it comes to technology around processing plants, how's it changed over the last 5-10 years?
It's amazing. We didn't have the telecoms or the connectivity, particularly in Australia. Some of the other countries had a different connectivity than us, but we're so big and so remote and our mining's out there. So we've had a few different changes in the automation and control, but not only that, the speed at which we're moving towards the new energy landscape. And where it mines, a perfect example is OTCMKTS Minerals and their West Musgrave deposit. Their project that they've just given FID on it, they've got a 300 megawatt power production system going in there out near the borders of three states with a 50 megawatt. So that's a variable amount of energy that we've got coming in that you need to be efficient, or you could use or lose in that as well. So how can you link the mining technology with this new landscape of power that we're moving towards? It's fascinating. Then the OEMs developing and what we're seeing in manufacturing around the world, all coalescing at the same time. So what we've seen in the last 5 years, just like with a lot of technologies, is you're moving up that hockey stick curve where you're moving faster than you've ever moved before.
Well, it's interesting. Just across these different groups, how important is collaboration here?
It's a different landscape from where I started my career 20 years ago, is we used to all be competing against one another. And then a lot of the end users tried to do it all in-house as well. There's twofold there. Everyone has their own specialties and their niches and experiences. But if you overlap that with today's challenge around skilled labour, particularly in Australia, particularly in the industrial segments, collaboration is more important than it's ever been. So where we will have an owner-operator mine with an engineering company, with an EPC and delivery company, with a technology and an OEM, with a connectivity company or telecoms company, all coming together to try and help deliver. And we talk about the mine of the future. It's no longer the mine of the future. It's the mine of today. And we're delivering it. And I've seen companies do that rapidly in their major projects. So collaboration is where we're going to get it for this country, for this region and this industry.
And Jess, you'll also be hosting an all-woman panel at IMARC. What's on the agenda?
Super excited about that as well. It's really lovely to see 5 technical women come together in the mineral processing realm, which is such a passion for me, and linking that with technology and getting everybody's opinions from their backgrounds as well. So we've got end users, we've got OEMs, technology, comms, laboratory and analytical in there, and how they're all using technology to make those mineral processing plants the most efficient and sustainable and profitable for all of the companies that they're working with. So really looking forward to the conversation with the ladies on that panel.
Well, just finally, Jess, drawing on your expertise here, when it comes to processing plants, say technology, automation, looking into your crystal ball, what are things looking like in the next 5, 10, 15 years?
Well, I can't wait to still be here in 10 years and see where we've gone in that compared to where we came from. I think we're going to be producing the lowest impact minerals and metals that we can. So the lowest carbon, the lowest water, the lowest consumables, the lowest waste, the highest efficiency that we can. And that's where I think we all want to be in mining. It's not just about digging stuff up. it is about doing it in a sustainable way.
Good to meet you. Jess, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.